If you ask any Harry Potter fan what the worst book of the series is, close to 90% would probably say either Chamber of Secrets or Order of the Phoenix. But why are these novels so inferior to the other ones? I'll cover the fifth installment in a separate video, but today, I'll explain the problem with Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. Hey everyone! If you're watching this and Chamber of Secrets is your favorite book, please comment below because there are, unfortunately, so few of you. I actually think that Chamber isn't as bad as most people seem to think it is, but there are still several problems with it that I'll get into right now. Spoilers for all seven Harry Potter books. I think the main aspect that makes Chamber subpar compared to the rest of the series is the lack of plot contribution in the long run. The whole book is centered around the Heir of Slytherin mystery, petrifications, and Tom Riddle's diary, which all eventually connect during the climax. But although these events get the reader pretty hooked, they're also only tangibly connected to the plot of the series as a whole. The other novels do a great job at this. Sorcerer's Stone introduces the wizarding world and necessary background, and Prisoner of Azkaban introduces Sirius and the Marauders, as well as Dementors. Goblet of Fire brings Voldemort back for the not really dead, and Order of the Phoenix illustrates the three-way battle between Harry and Dumbledore, Voldemort, and the Ministry. But Chamber of Secrets doesn't really do much for the rest of the series. Sure, it shows some of Voldemort's past and identity as Tom Riddle, but Half-Blood Prince goes into this with much greater detail. The only event that truly affected the series' plot, besides the appearance of Dobby, was Harry's destruction of the Diary Horcrux, which readers don't even know the importance of until Book 6. How many of you got to that page of Half-Blood Prince and thought, "So that's why I read Book 2?" And this is where we get to the root of the problem, that you barely know anything more about the series after the second novel than after the first. Of course, there are Wizarding World fun facts and information that readers pick up through every book, but in terms of new backstory and insight, there really isn't much. It makes Chamber of Secrets feel much more separated from the series than any of the other books. Another issue the novel presents is that the main villain turns out to be a child's diary. We go through hundreds of pages of anticipation to reveal who the Heir of Slytherin really is, only to find out that the culprit is merely a spirit inside of a journal. Again, we later find out that the diary was a Horcrux, making the plot much, much richer, but at the time, readers finished the book still not knowing how Riddle's diary even came to life. The diary was also finished off pretty quickly, with just one stab of the nearest pointy object lying around that just happened to contain basilisk venom, aka Horcrux repellent, but once again, readers don't know. You're left assuming that the diary was never that powerful and could have been destroyed by a lot of things, making the villain seem pretty weak after hyping it up during the whole book. So this, combined with the fact that it adds almost nothing to the plot of the series as a whole, is the problem with Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. But anyway, if you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe so you don't miss any future videos I make. Click the bell to make sure you're notified when I upload. Thanks for watching, see you later!